Hi, it's Paul. Today we're going to start looking at structured text, and we're not really going to do any programming in it, but we're going to do some exploring and get an idea for how it's similar and how it's different from the other languages. Eventually we're going to get into programming this traffic light, and you notice I put some counters down here so we can count some cars and do some other stuff. But for now, I just want to take a look at Studio 5000. All right, let's start with looking at the tags. Here's my parameters and local tags. And you notice here I've got some counters and timers. That's from our ladder logic. And over here for data type, these four here are timers. They're from ladder logic. And this counter, that's a function block diagram counter. I'll go to edit tags. I'm going to put in another counter. I'll just call it C2. And that I'm going to make a regular counter. Now you can see I've got a FBD counter and I've got a counter. Counters only work with ladder logic. FBD counters, they work with the advanced programming languages like structured text and function block diagram. Down here I've got some timers. I'm going to make another timer, call it T5. And I'm going to have a FBD timer. Okay, so there's an FBD timer. It's not the same as a timer. Timers are for ladder logic, FBD timers, function block diagram timer. Those are both for structured text and for function block. Structured text doesn't have its own timers and counters that uses the same ones as function block. Okay, so that's the first difference. Let's look at my main routine. My main routine, all I've got going here is I did a jump to subroutine to take me to traffic ST. And traffic ST, this is a routine that we're going to do in structured text. And then for comparison, I've got a blank one called traffic FBD for function block. I'm going to put some things in function block, and then I'm going to do the same thing in structured text just to look at some of the differences. So we already started talking about timers. I'm going to put in a timer. And if I go up here to timers and counters, there's a timer on with reset. And if I click on the ellipse, I see all my options, like timer timing is one of the ones we use a lot. So there's my timer on reset. Timer on 01. If I go back look at my tags, here's my timer on 01 function block timer. This is the one T5 I created that manually. This one, timer 01, that was created for me by function block diagram. Now let's go to structured text. So I want to use a timer here. First thing I have to do is tell it I want a timer. So I'm going to start typing. I know it starts with T, and it comes up with a bunch of suggestions. And I want to use this guy, timer on reset. Now I have to tell it which one I want to use. So I could use T5, that's the guy I just created. And I'll close my sentence with a semicolon. You need a semicolon at the end of every line in function block. I'm sorry, in structured text. So there I created a timer and I linked it to a tag. I'm going to do another one. TONR. And I'm going to call this guy T6. And notice when I do that, T6, it says no items. So I'm going to close that anyway. And a couple things are going on. It made this squiggly line under it. it's telling me that there's something going on. If I click on my verify routine, and we use this a lot in structured text, so I'm going to click on that. It says error line 2, timer on reset, parameter T6, tag is undefined. So I don't have a tag for that. It didn't make it automatically. I'm going to right click on it and new tag. And it brings up this dialog. Tag name is T6, that matches. It already knows that it's an FBD timer because I told it I'm going to use a timer on reset. So I'm going to hit create. Clears my errors. I'll go back to my tags. And there's my T6, my FBD timer. So it's gone and made my tag for me for my timer. Now I'm going to do something else. I want to just turn on one of these lights. So I'll take an input and an output. And my output, I'm going to use, let's use East Red. I'll hook these two together and I'll put a one in there. Now I'm sending a hot signal to East Red. That's going to turn that light on. In structured text, I'm going to do the same thing with the East Green. So I'll start typing and it comes up with a bunch of suggestions. So I can just keep typing or I can double click on, I want to use East Green. And then to set it as something, you use an assignment. And it's kind of like an equals, but it's a little bit different. So I use a colon equals. That means an assignment. And I'll put a one in there. End it with a colon. And I've got yellow. So let's check my routine. And it says my routine is fine. So I did the same thing in both places. If I go to ladder logic, I can go and I'll add a rung. And I can put an input, make that one. And I can put an output. And I'll use East Yellow. Okay, so it didn't like that. I don't need that. There we go. Verify routine and I'm all good. So here I sent hot signal to my East Yellow just by hooking it on a run. In function block, I hooked an input with a value of 1 to my East Red output. And in structured text, I assigned the value of 1 to my East Green. So those are kind of the first steps with structured text. And we're going to get into doing more with some timers and learn why structured text is such a popular programming language to use. Okay, for now that's enough to get us started. And I suggest what you do is create a routine with structured text and start putting some things in. I know I have a car sensor, so if I start typing car, there I've got my north car. So there's my input for my north car. And that's all I want to go over for now. Okay, thanks a lot.